Hey everybody, I'm here today to show you how to fix a broken chair leg with wood glue. This will be a simple tutorial, so let's get right into the video. As you can see right here, I have a chair leg. This is one of my dining room chairs, and I was sitting on it the other day and I heard a little crack, a little sound. And I looked down and I found this on the floor. And I realized that I broke part of the chair leg, okay? So I'm gonna show you how to fix it with wood glue. It's a very simple process. Now, if you have a complete break in the chair leg, or like part of the actual leg, the structure of it is broken, then you will have to use wood glue along with some nails and possibly some reinforcing wood to secure it in place. If you have a minor crack like this where it doesn't really involve the structural integrity of the chair, you could just use wood glue. But even if it's something structural, you should incorporate wood glue into the process. Very simple. Make sure the piece that you have fits properly. So as you can see, it fits properly, and if I glue it nice and tightly, I probably won't even have to sand it down or repaint it. It kind of just looks like a regular distressed crack in the chair, which is kind of normal. Plus, to be honest with you, my wife and I, well, more my wife, she's been talking about getting new dining room chairs for a long time, so I know it's gonna happen in the near future. So I don't wanna devote too much time to something that is, you know, just gonna be whatever, sold or whatever at a garage sale. So basically, you know, you wanna get some wood glue and you wanna apply it to both the area over here and then the actual chair piece. And the reason is because you want it to really adhere to every aspect of it. And you wanna also have on hand a wet paper towel or a wet, dinner Kleenex, I don't know what it's called, napkin, that's the word I'm looking for, and a dry one too, okay, just to wipe up any excess. So we're gonna start off, I just have some old wood glue here. I tested it out just to make sure that it's still good and it's still working. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna apply a little bit, we gotta really make its way down. Let's just apply a little bit onto the area right over here. Let's get my hand out of the way, as you can see right there. And you always should have you should always have, you know, some napkins or paper towels or toilet paper, because like no matter how good you are, it's going to be difficult to do this without making a mess. I should have even changed into my work clothes, but I'm kind of in my regular clothes right now because it should be really, really messy. So what I'm doing now is I'm just applying some wood glue to here, just a little bit. You don't need a ton, okay? Because you can always, if you realize you don't have enough, you can always pull it off and add more before it dries, right? So I think this is enough, and I'll show you. I basically applied wood glue all throughout there, okay? And I applied wood glue all on here, okay? Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put it in place. Woo! Oh no! Oh, I just got the wood glue on my pants. I knew I should have put my work clothes on. Okay, I'm gonna have to clean this up after. Anyways, you want to, and these are my good pants. I really like these pants. You wanna put it in place and sort of rub it around a little bit. Because as you rub it around a little bit, you're gonna be spreading out the glue all around, okay? You want the glue to be spread out all around. Then what you're gonna do, we're gonna wipe up the excess, okay? Very simple, wipe up the excess, just like that. I'm gonna start off by using a wet paper towel, just like that, okay? If you want to, like if you're gonna be sanding it and painting it, then you don't need to go crazy with the wiping part, because you're gonna be sanding it anyways and then repainting it. But if you're doing what I'm doing, which is kind of just a little patch job per se, then you definitely wanna do a good job at cleaning the glue, because as it dries up, you're gonna notice the wood glue when it dries up, okay? For the most part, it will not look like a simple distressed crack in the chair like I was talking about. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take a dry paper towel, a dry napkin, we're gonna dry it up. It's okay if you have a little bit of the wood glue on the outside of the crack, that's totally fine, a little bit. But definitely you don't want a lot, because then you're really gonna notice it and it's not gonna look good, okay? So what I've done now is I've cleaned up all the wood glue. Very important step. If you are working with the bottom of a chair like this, like I am right here, make absolutely sure that it is level, because if it's sticking out a little bit, it is gonna totally throw off the chair and how the chair is balanced. Now I have some sliders under here and some felt pads, so it won't make as big of a deal, but I mean, still, you really wanna do a good job at making sure that the bottom is perfectly lined up, Just like that. Make sure, like, put your finger there, put another piece of wood there, do something, make sure it's lined up, okay? One more time. You cannot do too good of a job wiping the glue. Like, I mean, when you think you're done, more will ooze out. So give it a quick minute, wipe it again, just like that, put it in place. And when you are ready to leave it alone, make sure you're good, because I'm telling you, it's gonna dry and it's gonna stick in place. So I know this is level. That looks good on that side, as you can see. This looks good on this side. So I am ready to leave it. Okay, now here is probably the hardest part. Don't touch it until the wood glue has dried. I know it's hard because you're gonna wanna touch it and make it perfect. Don't touch it, okay? Just don't touch it. The more you touch it, the harder it's gonna be for that wood glue to dry and to actually adhere properly. So just leave it alone, walk away, look on the container, figure out how long it's gonna take to dry, and leave it. And you know what, if you wanna be safe, even double that time. If it says it's gonna dry in 2 hours, leave it for 4 hours. There's really no harm. Let it dry, you'll be good to go. And that's it. In this video, I've shown you how to fix a broken chair leg with wood glue. If you like the video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.